This video is something I wish I had when I got my Supernote a year ago. In the next 12 or so minutes, I'll be going over some basic things you might want to know when getting started using an A5X or A6X. Let's begin with features specific to different types of files. The main ones I use on Supernote are notes, PDFs, and ebooks. My ebooks are mainly EPUB, but the Supernote can read a bunch of different file formats, which I'll put on the screen for your reference. All right, let's get started with notes. Notes are basically notebooks, so you can write on them, erase what you wrote, move it around, and you can change what type of paper you wrote on by changing your templates. Just go in your options, tap on templates, and you can choose from all the templates installed on your Supernote. You can also have more than one template per notebook. I mainly use the dotted line template that just came with a Supernote, but I linked to some other really nice free ones in the description box. If you want to install a template, put the PNG files in the My Style folder. And here's the correct format if you'd like to design your own. A cool thing about notes on Supernote is that you can add titles to them. You can see the titles in a notebook using this sidebar on the left. Titles are like a table of contents or like tabs in a paper notebook. They help you navigate from section to section really easily. To make a title, first we have to take the lasso tool, that is this one over here. Select what you want to turn into a title and tap on this icon. Really easy to remember since it's the exact same one as in the toolbar. And there we go. There are two main types of PDFs that I keep on my Supernote. There are some I keep on there to write on, so stuff like planners, while others are there for reading or for reference. Here's an example of a PDF planner. This particular one is hyperlinked, and that makes it really easy to go from the monthly view to the daily view, and just generally navigate around. This particular planner is free, and I'll put a link to it in the description box. Sometimes I see people ask if they can use a planner made for another device on their Supernote. Generally, the answer to this is yes, but there's a catch. Here's a planner I use that was actually designed for the Remarkable 2. It looks fine, and all of the links work, so I don't experience any problems using this on the day-to-day. But if you pull down the toolbar, you'll see that the toolbar actually covers part of the page. For this particular planner, it's not really a problem since it has tabs, so I can still navigate very easily. But the margins and layout are something that you should take into account if you're thinking of buying a planner that wasn't originally made for the Supernote. Or just hide your toolbar. So, what's it like to read a PDF on the Supernote? Now, this is an A6X, an A5X is obviously a bit bigger, but the navigation works exactly the same. You can zoom into a PDF in increments of 50%, and then you can move around the page by either swiping or by using the little navigation box in the corner. This is honestly enough for me since I don't really do extensive reading of PDFs on my Supernote. Most of the PDFs I have on there, I might need to read only a paragraph or two at a time, or I'm using it as a paperless alternative to printing out stuff for my various hobbies. But if you're planning on reading a lot of academic articles, you might want to think about if this PDF handling is enough for you because it's not very robust at the moment. That said, I have seen Supernote reps mention on the subreddit that landscape mode should be coming soon, and that would make things way easier since you could just view the top half and the bottom half of a PDF without really worrying too much about zooming. So here's to hoping that's coming in the next update. There are two ways of reading your ebooks on the Supernote. There's the Kindle app, and of course, there's the Supernote default reader. The Kindle app works basically like the Android app, because it is the Android app, and everything you can do on that app, you can pretty much do on this one. Change the layout, sync your reading. You do have to remember that since it's a third-party app, you can't do Supernote things on it, so you can't write on the pages or use other Supernote-specific features. But you can use your stylus in the place of your finger, which I find much easier for things like highlighting. And if you read books in languages other than English, you'll be happy to know that the dictionaries work and you can always install more. When it comes to the default reader, it's a little bit basic, but it works pretty smoothly. And of course, the upside is that you can write on your book pages and you can use other Supernote features. The layout you see right now is just what came with this particular ebook, but you do have options to change the margins, change the line spacing, and even install your own fonts. Though, and it makes total sense, you can't change around the layout after you've already added annotations to your books. Let's talk about some Supernote specific features. Quick access, stars, keywords, and digest. Except for digest, which doesn't work in notes, these features work in all of the file types that we just covered. Quick access is really easy. It refers to this collection of 1-4 links, which you can find at the bottom of your right sidebar. And clicking on any of these links will take you to a specific page. To add a specific page to your quick access, just go into your options, tap on Add to Quick Access, and you should see the link in your sidebar. When talking about stars on the Supernote, it can be a little confusing because there are actually two types of stars you'll see navigating around. There are these small ones in File View next to the files. Tapping on one of them marks that file as a favorite, and tapping on this bigger one in the corner shows you a list of all the files you've marked favorites. The other type is when you draw a star and Supernote turns it into a much prettier one in this case. These are used for marking specific pages. If you go to the left sidebar where all the titles and stuff are, you'll see an option to view all of the stars in that particular note or document. You can also search for stars throughout your whole device. Just go into the global search by swiping down. You can choose specific file types you want to look through and make sure you tap star mark. Tap search. You'll either get a list of files and how many stars are in each. Or if you switch to page view, you can view the specific pages that you drew stars on. I mainly use this feature to mark pending tasks or just things I want to remember. I think the easiest way to explain keywords is it's like putting a tag or a label on a specific page of your notes or your other documents. And you might be asking, okay, but how is this even useful? As an example, let's say I have a notebook that contains notes from my various work meetings over the past few months. As you can see here, I've already added titles, so that I can browse these work meetings based on their date. But what if I wanted to find meetings not based on their date, but based on what was discussed, so based on the main project or initiative that we talked about during that meeting? We can tag a page with a topic, and then easily find all the pages tagged with the same topic later using keywords. I just have to select my text, here it's the name of the project we just talked about, tap on the K, confirm it, and if we look in the navigation for the document, you'll see the keywords listed on top. Even if these two meetings are a bit far apart in the notebook, they're listed next to each other here because the keywords are listed in alphabetical order, which means that pages tagged with the same keyword are grouped together, making them easier to find. But what really makes keywords powerful is that you can search for every page tagged with that keyword throughout your whole device. With just one search, you can find all the pages in your planner notebook, in your notes, in your documents, all tagged with the same topic. How this looks is we just pull up the global search. Let's use the same keyword as we did for the first example and look for everything related to Project Y. We can pick what file types we want to look through and make sure you check off the keyword box. In File View, we'll get a list of files that have pages tagged with that keyword. And then on Page View, we'll get a list of pages that have that keyword on them. I find this a much more efficient way of linking together pages and information about the same topic without having to navigate to each page or each file one by one. If I'm studying a book on my Supernote, I'm probably using the Digest. The Digest feature will work on PDFs, but they have to be PDFs with a text layer. An easy way to check if a PDF has a text layer is to try and copy text from it while it's on your computer. I find using the digest is much easier than what I used to do, which is copy and paste sentences to compile them, or keep separate handwritten notes. Just draw brackets around the text. You can tap on what you bracketed to add notes. Tap on that highlight to bring up a note page, which is very generously sized. You might notice this little circle here, which can cover up some of your text. To get rid of that, you just have to go into your settings and turn Show Annotation Digest Settings off. With that setting off, if we go back to the book, it's just the underlines and the brackets. Everything you've drawn brackets around, and the notes you've taken, if any, will be compiled in your digest. If you want a PDF copy of your digest, just hold one entry, select which entries you want to export, or just hit select all, then tap export. This will make a PDF copy of your digest, which you'll find in your export folder, which you can view on your computer just like a normal PDF. You might be asking, does the Supernote have handwriting conversion? At the moment, it can't convert a note into text, although technically it is converting some of your handwriting so you can fill in text fields and so that you can make keywords. The only way to do handwriting conversion of larger amounts of text is by writing in a Word document. But while you can technically write out a whole page of text and convert it on Word, it's not the fastest. So while that's converting, I'm just going to take a second to say that I actually really do enjoy proofreading on the Supernote. I think it handles proofreader's marks and inserting and deleting words and phrases really well. If you're like me and prefer printing out your documents because you find it helps you spot more typos, this is a great paperless alternative, which is also more efficient than having to manually enter your changes in Word. And even though I sometimes write in a language not officially supported by Supernote, I find that it recognizes it pretty well as long as I write in print and not in cursive. If you wanted more specific tips and tricks, I have another video on my channel that you can check out. I plan to make more videos about Supernote features, ways I use the Supernote, but if there's something you're curious about or would like to see more about, just leave me a comment. Thanks for watching.